Praise the Lord, my dear wonderful friends. Thank you for tuning into another edition of Times of Refreshing. It is indeed a great joy and honor for me to come and share God's word with all of you. I pray that as you listen to this message, your life will be greatly blessed. And what I'm about to share is a practical experience that we can apply into a practical life. If we listen to this message with an open heart, I believe that God can transform your life. I want to talk to you about the people of faith versus people of fear. Are we under fear or are we walking in faith? Many people are walking under fear. They're afraid of failures or fear of death or fear about future. Whatever fear they are under, they become slave of that fear. So today I want to talk to you about how to overcome this fear and grow in our faith. Book of Numbers chapter 13 talks about an incident where God asked Moses to send out spies to see the land of Canaan. The purpose and objective was this: see what kind of land is Canaan, what kind of people are living there, what kind of vegetation, what kind of fruits are there. God already knew the answer to this, but God was sending the people to test their faith, to test their growth in their spiritual maturity that we go through sometimes in our life as well. Everything that happens in our life, God knows. Even if it seems opposite to our expectation, God knows everything. Bible says, steps of a righteous one is ordered by God. Have a confidence in your heart that the steps that you're taking is ordered by God when you're a child of God. Book of Numbers chapter 13 verse 18. The objective was this: see what the land is like. Didn't God know what the land is like? Of course God did. And whether the people who live in it are strong or weak. Didn't God know that whether there were strong people or weak people? Of course God knew. Whether there are few or many, how is that land which they live? Is it good or bad? Of course, God knew the land was good. Otherwise, God would not have brought them out of the land of Egypt into this specific land. God knew everything. But how did people react when spies were selected from each tribe, each of the 12 tribes? They checked out the land. They spent 40 days over there. When they were in the land of Canaan for 40 days, it's important for us to know that they did not face any opposition. They did not face any problem. Whether they were giants or grasshoppers or big people, small people, animals, wild animals, whatever it is, but they did not even face one problem in 40 days. And they came back to give the report to the chief or the leader, Moses. What kind of report did they give? When we read Book of Numbers chapter 13 verse 26 on, we can see the report. And here we see the response of the people of fear versus people of faith. I want to tell you 10 things that we can learn from the incident or the experience that this 12 tribal leaders experienced. How can we apply this into our practical life? Let's listen to this. I want to tell you 10 things that we can learn from this incident. Number one, they all experienced the same thing as the people of faith. In other words, people of faith and people of fear saw the same land, experienced the same thing. That's number one. All of us sees the same thing. All of us face the similar circumstances all our life long. Sometimes we go through sickness in our life. Sometimes we go through financial problems in our life. Sometimes we go through problems that our children are facing. All of us goes through same circumstances and we see the same thing. How do we react to it? That is the key. Your reaction will cause the next reaction. Every action creates a response. The action that you are taking today will cause a negative reaction or a positive reaction. What kind of reaction are you experiencing today? Numbers chapter 13, verse 24 through 26. It says like this: a place was called Valley of Ishkol because of the cluster which the sons of Israel cut down from there. When they returned from spying out the land at the end of 40 days. So they saw the same Valley of Ishkol. They were able to cut down the grapes and brought pomegranate and all kinds of things. But the response was different. So number one lesson that we can learn is that they experienced the same thing as the people of faith. Number two, they see good evidence. The people of faith and people of fear saw good evidence. What does that mean? That means they saw the same fruits. They saw the same circumstances. But here is what the difference is. Number three is that the people of fear, they turn their reaction or conversation to negative quickly. The people of fear always speaks words of fear. Are you speaking the words of fear today? Their conversation turned negative. From positive things to negative things quickly. Verse 28. The people said, "Nevertheless, who live in the land are strong. The cities are fortified and very large. And moreover, we saw the descendants of Anak there. Amalek is living in the land of Negev. And the Hittites and the Jebusites and the Amorites are living in the hill country. Canaanites are living by the sea and by the side of Jordan." Their conversation was talking about the people who live there, and they started explaining the giants who are living there. God already knew. God had a purpose when God brought them out of the land of Egypt from the bondage and slavery of Pharaoh. God knew everything. But these people were talking about the problems rather than the God they knew. Imagine this. They saw miracles every single day. Can you imagine that? As they were traveling, pillar of cloud by day was ahead of them. A pillar of fire was there in the night. All they have to do is just look at the pillar of cloud and understand the presence of God. All they had to do is just look at this presence and know that God's presence is with them. Do you realize God's presence is with you? Many times we see extraordinary things every day and it becomes normal to us. Even the fact that you're able to breathe is a miracle. But we forget. During the times of COVID, you know how many people were gasping for air? People were running and finding out whether this hospital or that hospital has oxygen tanks available. People were searching for air to breathe. The fact that you're able to breathe this morning is a miracle of God. Don't forget. And then they saw manna from heaven coming down every single morning. Meat, quail was coming down in the evening. There was no sick person, feeble among them. Can you imagine? The clothes that they were wearing grew with them. The sandals they were wearing grew with them. Every single day they saw the miracle of God. But now when they saw problems, they saw the problems as bigger than God himself. We are like that too many times. When you face the problems, are you seeing the problem as greater than God is? If you are, then you are a person of fear. Do not bow down. Do not become a slave to fear. We serve the Lion of the tribe of Judah. the King of Kings and Lord of Lords is with you. Bible says, don't you know that you are the temple of the Holy Spirit? In other words, you are a carrier of the presence of God. Wherever you go, you are guaranteed victory. Why? Because the Creator of the ends of the world is with you. That's why we should not speak the words of fear. They started talking about negative things rather than the positive things. They started saying the people over there are giants. And number four lesson that we can learn is that they build on negative things and make it worse. If you look at Numbers 13, verse 28 and 29, it says like this: the people over there, Amalekites living in the land. Who are the Amalekites? I don't know if you remember in the book of Exodus, the first battle that the children of Israel had to face was against Amalek. They took victory over Amalek. When the hand of Moses was lifted high, children of Israel had victory. Imagine, they were slaves. They had no weapons. They had no training. They did not know how to fight, but God gave them supernatural victory against the Amalekites. But now when they saw Amalek, they were afraid. Why? They forgot that God has done marvelous things against Amalek before. So they build on the negative stuff, negative story, and make it worse. They said like this: the land through which we have gone in spying it out is a land that devours its inhabitants, and the people whom we saw in it are men of great size. Two things they said. They said, the land over there devours the people. In other words, the earth will open and swallow them up. Do you know any place like that where the earth will just open and swallow you up? No, it does not happen. Well, that's what they were saying. They said, everyone over there are giants. Do you know any place like that where even the children are giants? No. So they were exaggerating the negative story to make it worse. That's number four. They build on negative story and make it worse. That's the sign of a person of fear. And number five, they reject the encouragement and bring down the faith of others. If you are a person of fear, everyone who surrounds you is affected by your fear. So it's very important for you to know that you should not be surrounding yourself with a person of fear. Because if you're constantly talking to a person of fear, if you are taking advice from a person of fear, that person of fear will bring you down as well. Bring you down with them. They are depressed, you will be depressed. They are full of anxiety, you will become anxious as well. They reject and encourage the faith of others. But then there were two persons, Caleb and Joshua. Caleb said like this in verse 30. Then Caleb quieted the people before Moses and said, we should by all means go up and take possession of it, for we will surely overcome. That's a sign of a person of faith. Caleb said, let us go. Let us go take possession of the land. You may be saying it's a giant, but my God is greater than the giants that are living over there. My God has promised me it will happen. Do you have that same faith? If God has promised you, it will come to pass. If God has said that you will be head and not tail, it will come to pass. But what is the key? The key is faith. Book of Hebrews says that without faith, it's impossible to please God. Do you want to please God? Have faith in God. Without faith, we cannot please God. What is this faith? This faith, it believes that what God has said, it will come to pass in my life. Goodness and mercy will follow me all the days of my life. Blessing will follow me. I don't have to chase after the blessing. Blessings will follow me all the days of my life. And then They exaggerate and instill fear in others. The more they hang out with the people of fear, other people of faith, and you're a person of fear, the person of fear will instill more fear into the people of faith. And then they have a poor self-image. They don't have confidence. They don't have confidence for many reasons. But they consider themselves as failure. They say, I cannot do it. Why? Because they are looking at their own strength rather than the God they serve. When you look at your own strength, you will fail. If you're looking at the Red Sea all by yourself, you will fail. If you're looking at the fortress that's standing against you, you will fail. But when you imagine, when you have faith that God is there with you in front of the fortress, in front of Red Sea, against the mountains that are standing against you, you will overcome. And then number 8, they cause failure. They will stop others from reaching the potential that God has given them. People of fear, or spirit of fear, is contagious. It spreads. It's like a virus. If you're a parent, don't be negative with your children. Because what happens is, if you have fear, that will spread to your children and their children and their children. But if you're a parent, if you're a dad or a mom, that you're telling your children, you can become someone great. You will be successful. God will lift you up. God will make you higher and not bow and not beneath. When you speak the words of life into them, your children will be greatly blessed as well. When you speak good things to your loved one, rather than being complaining all day long or causing words of fear into their life, words are like seeds. What you sow, you will harvest, you will reap. Let me say that one more time. Words are like seeds. What you sow is what you get. If you are sowing the words of fear, you will get back fear. But if you are sowing the words of faith, you will reap faith. You will reap blessings. And then 8, they cause others to fail in reaching their potential. When you read chapter 14, verse 1 to 3 in Numbers, it says like this, that all the congregation lifted up their voice and cried, and people wept that night. Everyone was weeping. Everyone was crying. Everyone said to themselves that we cannot go and possess the land. How did they get this idea? Because of the 10 people who became negative and full of fear. They caused that fear to be spread. What happened as a result of it? These people whom God wanted to take and lead them to the land of Canaan, they started wandering for 40 years in the wilderness. That was not God's plan. God did not want them to wander in the wilderness for 40 years. But it was their own sayings that caused them to wander in the wilderness for 40 years. Some of us are wandering in the wilderness for 40 years because of fear. Are you in a wilderness stage? Are you struggling in your life? And it could be that the words of fear that you have spoken, you're reaping, you're harvesting it. People of Israel wandered for 40 years. They missed out on the very best that God had for them. They could have crossed the land of Canaan within weeks, but instead, generation was lost because of the fear that they had. Only 2 people, Joshua and Caleb, and their children, the next generation, was the one who possessed the land that God had given them. They all, the people of fear, they all died in the wilderness. And number 9 is that they declare judgment on their end, negating what God had for them. Let me say that one more time. They spoke judgment for themselves. What do I mean? Let's read Numbers chapter 14 verse 2. All the sons of Israel grumbled against Moses and Aaron, and the whole congregation said to them, "Would that we had died in the land of Egypt, or would that we had died in this wilderness." In other words, it's better for us to die in the wilderness. That's what they said. That's exactly what happened to them. They declare their own judgment. The people of fear declare their own judgment. My life will not be prospered. I won't have a good life. My children won't have a good life. I will fail. I will fail this exam. I won't get a good job. I won't have peace in my life. Every single day I will have problems in my life. If you are the person who are saying that constantly, you are declaring judgment on yourself. The people who said it's better for us to die in the wilderness, they all died in the wilderness. It wasn't God's fault. They declared the judgment against themselves. Life and death is under the authority of tongue. The fruit that you pick, you will enjoy. That's what the word of God says. Life and death is under the authority of tongue, my friend. And then number 10, fear. The people of fear distorts God's viewpoint. Fear causes us to miss what God is saying to us. People of fear can't see what God is saying. People of fear will become blind to what God is saying. I want to tell you today, if you have fear in your life, you cannot hear what God is saying. You cannot see what God is saying. God could be doing spectacular things in your life, but you can't see it because fear has blinded you. As you listen to this message, I want you to turn around. Put that fear away. How can you increase faith in your life? How can you get rid of fear? Number one thing that you can do is attitude of gratitude. In other words, you should always give thanksgiving to God. But that's why the Bible says, enter into His gates with thanksgiving. So we must enter into a new day with a heart of thanksgiving. We should always be proclaiming God's goodness in our life. That's what people of faith does. Every single morning when they get up, they are thanking God for another day. Thanking God for what God has done in their life. That's why David said in Psalms, bless the Lord, O my soul. All that is within me, bless His holy name. Bless the Lord. David is saying, bless the Lord, O my soul. He's talking to himself and asking his soul to bless the Lord, name of the Lord. That's a medicine against fear. And number two is what you feed is what makes you stronger. What you are feeding, that's what makes you stronger. So if you're feeding fear, fear grows. If you're feeding faith, faith grows. If you're feeding the Word of God grows. If you're feeding God's goodness grows in your life. And number three, God dependencies. We need to depend on God every single day. Lord, I need you. We need to say, Lord God, I need you more than ever. Have that strong belief in your heart that we cannot do anything without God. We cannot do anything without God. That's the attitude you need to have. And when you do that, faith will grow. As you listen to this message, Bible says that faith comes from hearing and hearing the word of God. Listen to the word of God. Faith will grow in your life. Rather than worldly stuff. Rather than things that gives fear. Hallelujah to the Lamb of God. So I want to encourage you. I want to exhort you today. Learn from the people of fear. And let's take a lesson and make it a point to have your faith grow in your life. So today we talked about 10 things that we can learn from the people of fear. Number one, I'll just quickly recap. Number one, people of faith and people of fear experience the same thing. The circumstances are always the same. It may be slightly different, but we all face the similar problems. Number two, they see good evidence. People of faith and people of fear see good evidence. You're alive is a good evidence. You have food to eat is a good evidence. And number three, they quickly turn their conversation from negative to positive. Number four, they build on the negative story and make it worse. Children of Israel said, they are giants, but we are grasshoppers. They are big people, but we are small people. The earth will swallow us up. Number five, they reject the faith and cause other people to fail. They cause all the children of Israel to weep and cry. And number six, they exaggerate and instill fear in others. The people that are surrounding the people of fear, they will experience fear also. Number seven, they have poor self-image. Number eight, they cause others to fail in reaching their potential. And then number nine, they declare judgment on themselves. They spoke, and what they spoke is what happened. They said, we're going to die in the wilderness. All of them died in the wilderness. Number 10, fear distorts God's viewpoint. Fear made them blind. Fear caused them not to see God's goodness and supernatural provision every single day. So today, if you are a person of fear, step away. Make a conscious decision. I am not going to speak the words of fear. I am not going to speak the words of doubt. I'm not going to speak anything negative. When a negative thought comes, I'm going to tell myself, I'm going to bless the Lord. I'm going to give thanks to what God has done in my life. I am going to know and I am going to understand and realize that the presence of God is with me. And I'm going to feed the word of God in my life. I'm going to feed the goodness of God in my life. And I'm going to depend on God for my faith. I'm going to depend on everything that I face in my life through with my God. David said like this, I will leap over a wall with my God. I can run against a troop by my God. I will leap over a wall with my God. You can do everything with God. You cannot do anything without God. May God bless you. I pray that this life lesson, this message was a practical message that changes your life. I pray that God will bless you. God will transform your life as you listen to this message. Let us grow in faith. Remove fear. You're a champion in the sight of God. God's presence is with you. You're not an ordinary person. You're an extraordinary person. Why? Because God, Almighty God, is with you. God bless you.